The MSSQL extension in VS Code has been getting some revamps. Learn all about it and get a hint at what's coming this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Carlos, a product manager on the SQL team, leading all of our VS Code and GitHub types of experiences. So, Carlos, thanks so much for coming on the show.
Hey, thanks for having me once again, Anna. Happy to be here.
Always great to have you on the show. And today, I'm really excited because you have promised a demo-only type of session where you're just going to take us through everything that's been going on in VS Code in the MSSQL extension. Now, maybe before we get into all that, can you tell us a little bit about maybe the MSSQL extension in VS Code and what you and the team have been working on?
Of course. Yeah. So thanks for asking that question. That's very important. So the MSSQL extension VS Code is an open source and free extension you can find in the VS Code marketplace that you can install to interact with your Azure SQL databases. So that means that you can connect to a SQL server running on your local machine, an Azure SQL database on Azure. And we introduced a new set of UI-rich features. That's how we call it. Because the previous extension was there, has been on GA for a long period of time, but now we introduced the new UI features by the time Ignite. So it has been a couple months since then. So I want to show you what is new.
Awesome.
So let's go ahead and take a look. As you said, where do we start? So we start from here, from the marketplace. The first step is to install the MSSQL extension. So as you can see, I just searched by MSSQL, to type the words, and I already have the extension installed. I have this environment with an app, so I'm all set. That's it. But, however, when you install the extension for the very first time, because we're introducing this new set of UI features, you will see a prompt. So let me show you the prompt. Because my environment is already like configured, I need to reload VS Code. That would take a couple of seconds. All right, so as you can see, I got this prompt that asked me, do you want to enable the experiences in an MSSQL extension and reload VS Code? And I am going to click yes. If you don't want to use the prompt, you can set the same configuration using the JSON or the UI VS Code, and it's a couple of settings, and that's it. So I'm all set. I have the latest and greatest version of the MSSQL extension, and I'm ready to go. So let's start by the basics. Let's connect to my local database. So as I said, I have an app. This is a Node.js application or JavaScript, I guess. I want to connect to my local database, and my local database already exists here because guess what? I'm using dev containers. So I'm using one of the templates that we have that comes with a sample database. So my container is already there, so I can just connect. I am going to proceed to enter the information about my connection string. As you can see, we support parameters, connection string, and Azure Browse if you want to connect to Azure. So I'm going to go with the local host here for the server name, the user where I created the container, and I guess that's it. I can just simply click connect, and I should connect to my database. This is something I was expecting. It's reminding me like, oh, you didn't click on enable trust server certificate. So those kind of things are the new UI features you will see that we're introducing with this new version of the extension. We also introduced a couple of things related to Azure. When you have a firewall rule that is not set yet, the extension can help you to set the rule to make sure your IP can be allowed so you can connect to your database. So let's click on here. Let's connect. And I'm in. So something really cool about the new version of the extension that didn't exist in the past is that now we introduce a couple of things here. The first one is that we can edit the connection. So that's wonderful. That was a highly requested feature on GitHub. So now if I want to make changes to my connection, I can just do it from here and just click connect and that's it. And as you can see, we have a panel which we show the saved connections or recent connections, so you can take it from there. So if I want, let's say, create a new connection again, it's click on here, and I want to connect to Azure. I just simply click on here, and it's going to ask me to log in, of course, because it's using Enter ID, and there we go. So if I click on connect, I should be able to connect to my Azure SQL database. So that's it. It's a very simple experience. We try to keep it light. Of course, if you want to take a look at band features, we have those settings for you. So it's a very complete experience, I guess. And we are looking for more feedback. And
awesome. And yeah, what I love about this, Carlos, is that not only are you making it easy for me to figure out all the things that I need to input to get connected, but also, you showed that example of how, like, when stuff goes wrong, which inevitably it does when you're doing development work, you're giving me some helpful error messages as well as, like, guidance. Like, hey, you need to trust this, or hey, you need to add this firewall rule and let's do it. So right. I love it.
Yeah, it's always good to get those reminders. So from the new experience, we also introduced a couple of things here. I don't know if you can see, but we have, let me zoom in a little bit. So we have these new icons here at every single level of the Object Explorer. Now we can do filters. So it's very simple. As you will guess, like, I can click on here and I get this panel open where I can just simply filter my objects by a single keyword. For example, I'm going to do it with book. That's it. But voila, simple, as you will expect it, right? So that's something new we'll introduce. There is another icon here, very interesting. And this is the table designer. So the new table designer is a UI experience that opens this little panel here where you can, like, design your tables using this kind of wizard, right? So it's a simple form. So let's say I want to create a table of magazines, and I go, and I already have the ID. That's what something you mentioned, right? So as a developer, there are a few things probably I can't forget. So it's telling me, okay, you need a primary key, and it's already set for me. So it has a primary key, has identity. Of course, you can change that. And you will see the changes occurring on this panel as well. So the panel below, if I add a column and I'd say a description, this panel changes according to the changes I'm making. Yeah, so it's very intuitive. So here, let's go with Bartkar. And where is it, Bartkar? And I'm all set, basically. And I just can, from here, open in an editor, just if I want to save this script for whatever reason. If I want to copy, because I am not good with T-SQL, and somebody asked me, hey, can you help me to create a table? And of course, I can use this, copy the script, paste it in somewhere else, and I'm all set. Or if you want to publish the change, you can do it from here. It explains what is going on. It asks for your consent, basically, to make the change and push the change to the database. And we can just update the database. And it took like seconds. I don't know if you saw it, but the table is here. So it was really quick, super quick. Let me check the time. Yeah, we have a couple minutes left. So another thing that is very cool in the extension now is the query results. So the query results panel or pane has changed. So let's say we have an app. So I said we have an app, right? So we have an app here. And let's say we have all information about authors. So I have it here, all good. So my app is working as expected. I get my results back. But I want to quickly check what is the data, how the data looks from the database side. So if I do a right click over the table authors here and I select the top 1,000, I got my results back. But let's imagine I'm working on this app. I mentioned an app, remember, at the beginning, Anna? So I have this app. It's a backend, very simple. So I am checking the information about my, reviewing the information about my authors. So I have what my API is returning to me, but I want to compare that to my database, right? To my data living on my database. So one thing I can do here is, I saw it before, I got my results. And we got some feedback from this. Like, this is probably not very intuitive when you are looking results side by side. And we introduced this option that does this. Let me see. There we go. All right. So now you can have your results in a different tab. And when you have an app and you are comparing data against, like, side by side, you can opt to use this view. And I don't know if you saw it, but there was a very small prompt
Yeah.
That asked me.
It said, if like, I wanted... do you want to always do this?
Exactly. So it's up to you. We are like introducing changes, but at the same time, giving flexibility for developers. If they really like this like way to visualize results, they can just do it. And I get it because it's very useful. And last one thing from the query results, there are new things here that we introduce. There is an option to get the estimated execution plan. You can get the actual execution plan as well if you execute the query, of course. And as again, we have the, introduced this capability to have a new tab. From here, you can also zoom in, zoom out, like save the execution plan. So plenty of options for developers here if they want to understand what's going on with their queries. So awesome. I guess that's it. That's all I have, Anna.
I love it. I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers did as well. For our viewers, like, go check this out. Go get the extension, play with it. Let us know what you think. I'm sure, Carlos, you and the team are looking for lots of feedback. Any hints you can give us for what you guys are looking at?
Any hints? Oh, okay. So I can say that AI is very popular nowadays. So we might be doing something like around AI, about AI. I don't know. We're just little. Looking at options right now.
Cool. Awesome. So folks, you heard it here first. You want to check out this extension. And of course, like Carlos mentioned, it's all open source. So if you have feedback, leverage the GitHub repo. We'll put some links in the description for you to go learn more. Leave us a comment. Let us know what your favorite thing you saw is today. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.